part two of West London Wine School's first session. The first one we looked at was the Loire Valley wines. Now we're going to look at the four Burgundy wines of this part, of the introductory part, session one. To really give you a feel for Burgundy, it's important to look at really the three major grapes. There are four, but the three major grapes. That's Chardonnay, of course, making some fantastically famous styles like Meursault, Pouligny, Montrachet, and regional Chardonnay as well. Pinot Noirs from villages like Volnay, from Gevrey, Chambertin, and so on. But also Gamay, which is your staple grape, really, the backbone grape of Beaujolais, Novarro, Village, and all of the crew villages as well. So these four wines, which is the second part, the last four wines and the eight wines of session one, really are picked to give you that snapshot of those three major grape varieties. The two Chardonnays, one which is a northern Burgundian Chardonnay, which is a Chablis. It's a very crisp style, very acidic, wonderful style. And then we move on to a Burgundy, a Bourgogne Chardonnay, which has got more sort of buttery, oaky notes. A Fleury from Bouchard, Père et Fils, and then finally onto a Valmet. So let's have a taste, first of all, of this one. This is from Majestic, around £10. It's a Jean Bourguignon Chablis. Classic sort of style, 09. Must be drunk quite young Chablis, most of the sort of average stuff. And also very well chilled. Have a go at this. Lovely, absolutely wonderful. Classic. If you're a person who loves those big, sort of oaky, rich wines, this isn't for you. Chablis is classically light, it's classically delicate, with great sort of acidity. It's a wonderful food wine, very versatile, because it goes with fish and it goes with cheeses like goat cheese, brilliant match for it, and also seafood too. Crisp, greenish sort of apple there. Lovely minerality as well. It's not flinty, it's not smoky mineral like the Puy Fumé of the Sauvignon Blanc. This one's much more manageable. But it does have hints of slightly riper notes, this as well. There's like a little bit of white peach or something in there. So it's got nice citrusy flavours, an apple, good acidity with those flavours, a little bit of ripeness, and a little bit of mineral. Have a taste. Wonderful, refreshing. Today it's something like 28 degrees outside. It's so hot. This kind of wine matches this weather brilliantly well. It's refreshing, great acidity. It's not serious, it doesn't make you think too much about it, but nice apple notes, lovely little bit of citrus, which is all this zest coming through. Not so much mineral. Now the mark of quality in Chablis is the lovely mineral length that keeps on going, and that's more reserved for the Premier Crus and the Grand Crus. But this one is just a standard Chablis, and it does exactly what it says on the tin. It's a good, refreshing style. Very good. It's the non-oaked style of Burgundy. Chablis is the non-oaked style. Now we move on to a Bouchard Hainefil, which is a general Bourgogne Chardonnay. Around 40%, 35-40% of the blend of this Chardonnay has actually been matured in oak, so it should be a little bit richer. Same price point. Let's see if this is a more better expression Chardonnay. Yeah, exactly. Now, on the nose, it's not all this real zestiness, it's more riper apple, peach, hints of apricot, the quincy notes come through. And then there's this very soft, creamy, buttery, edge of vanilla sort of touch. But it's not overt. Don't cast your minds back to Australian, big, beefy, oaky alcohol Chardonnays. Nothing like that. This one is more delicate and really just soft and easy. That's fantastic on the nose. Same grape, but just majorly found from the bulk of Burgundy, the Côte d'Or, the Mâconnais, and the Chardonnay. Mm. softer, acidity is lower, nowhere near as sharp as the Chablis. Lovely little creamy, buttery nose. There's that peach and melon comes through. Lovely. I mean, I'm personal on this. Wine is a subjective thing, you know this. This is more my kind of thing. It has more balance to it, more softer notes. And I still find it slightly refreshing. So, Chablis is good, but for me, this one's just an edge better because it's got more to it. It's only $8.99 from Waitrose, so very good value for money there. And that's the different style. And that's the wonderful thing about Chardonnay from one region like Burgundy. Diversity. It's not just one style. You can have the light, delicate Chablis, or these medium styles like this Bourgogne, white Burgundy, or you can get those real rich monsters like Pouligny Montrachet, Meursault, and some.